any much suspicion that I am a double agent. I am not, sir. I'm content.
Well, there's no British around right now. Nobody can hear.
The women are known to talk much, sir. I only want my freedom. I am not a spy. I am not a double agent.
Yeah, I didn't think you were.
They say that I have been recruited by Lafayette. You've heard of him, have you not?
Yes.
I know not the man. They call him the boy general. At least I've heard my master talk about him. A favorite of General Washington, they say.
We don't. Many people weren't able to make it in.
Yes. I tell you, many of the trenches here have been dug by the hundreds of Negroes who have followed Cornwallis up from the Carolinas. But if this room is true, that food is becoming a problem. Already he is not able to feed the horses, and so have ordered them slaughtered, Cornwallis, that is. I'm afraid that what will be the lot of the hundreds of Negroes who have followed him up from the south? Yes, the British have already conquered Georgia in this year of our Lord, 1781, and much of South Carolina, and they have come up through North Carolina and so have been here now for some 3 or 4 weeks. But I have heard rumor among the officers, and they speak freely and callously sometimes, that if push comes and there is the food becomes scarce, that perhaps Cornwallis will not keep his promise to the Negroes, the hundreds of them who have followed him up. This does not fare well for them or myself, you understand. I, like them, have cast my lot with the British. But one does not know the future, sir. I miss my master, William Armistead Jr., sometimes, but not much, as I served as his body servant. I, just as a young lad, you understand, I was with him.
You were from New Kent, right?
Indeed, sir, I am. I am, sir. And I tell you, sir, that many times William Armistead Bob Jr.'s father is a very wealthy man, and so he was able to employ a tutor, you understand, to come to the house there to educate and teach his son. As William Armistead Jr.'s body servant, I am to stay with him at all times and be at his beck and call. So I have been present many times when his tutor taught him.